The school actually started 4 years ago, and it was founded by the association. The name in Spanish is La Asociación Padres de Familia por Educación de Cofradía. And there are a bunch of parents in the community who really felt a need for affordable bilingual education to be present in this community. To their perception, having a bilingual education just opens so many more doors for their children moving into the job market. And so they approached our founder and spoke to her about how they really wanted to have a school here. She had been working in this community before. They wanted her to recruit the teachers for them. And there were a lot of challenges at that point because it was so sudden. They were talking about opening a school within 4 months. And she had to go back and recruit these teachers, but there was not an actual school here to recruit them to. And they were just so passionate about it that they said, you know, don't worry about that. We will get a school here, we will get permission to operate a school, we'll build it. You do what you do best, getting us teachers, and we'll do what we need to do to support you.
My teacher name is Miss Naomi.
What do you like about Miss Naomi?
I like she how to say tomar en calma.
Tomar en calma. She's calm.
She's calm.
I maybe it's because the kids are older, but I feel like school wasn't as big an influence as in their lives as it is for the kids here. They were all into different stuff and video games, and like the girls were all, you know, really girly, and it was just there were more options of stuff for kids to do, like somewhere in the basketball or, you know, some, I don't know, go-karts or video games or whatever. And here the kids go to school and then they go home and they spend the rest of the day either watching TV or playing video games or sitting around in the street really bored. So I think they really like school, and I feel like here I don't compete with as many outside things. Mm-hmm.
But here, like, you really do have a blank palette to create your own classroom, like how you want to shape your kids and how you think is best to teach them.
We didn't have a lab, we didn't have heat, like, you know, Bunsen burners. We had a couple microscopes, most of them broke. You know, we didn't have very lot of resources, so that was actually kind of a fun challenge. I was like, we're going to do physics. It's for physics, we can do a lot of math, a lot of graphs, and we can do experiments involving running and throwing rocks. And so we threw rocks at the wall. We did things that I thought were really fun, that the kids thought were fun.
I guess I'm really just surprised at how advanced some of the kids are. I expected that half the class would be taught in Spanish and half would be taught in English for pretty much the entire class is taught in English, and they have to deal with pretty advanced concepts that there's no way I would have been able to deal with in Spanish when I was that age.
I was mainly just super impressed with the students and with how much potential they had and how much passion and like creativity and hope they had, and how learning English was so empowering.
But the kids here, they're a lot nicer to us, and they're more generous. They're not, I don't know.
They're more excited. And
yeah, they're more, exactly. They're more outgoing. They're not as competitive with each other.
And it ain't no use in the turning on your light, babe. The light I never know.
Competition.
Mm.
It was a rail jam.
Woo!
And 3 a.m. was like,
delicious!
But we never did too much talking anyway. But don't think twice, it's alright.
So the transition was that thinking of I need to find a career where I'm always working for social empowerment, for improving the community, that was moving back towards what I had in school in a way. I wanted to find something that filled my time with that. And that's exactly what I found here. I mean, it's very, very time consuming. But every second that I spend working, I'm really happy that I'm able to do it. I'm told
I give her my heart, but she wanted my soul. But don't think twice, it's all right.